Ladies and gentlemen, it's our extreme honor and pleasure to be joined by Shri Hardeep Singh Puri, Honorable Minister of Civil Aviation, Government of India, on Day 3 of Wings India 2020 Ministerial Plenary. Also joining him on the dais is Shri K.T. Rama Rao, Honorable Minister of Industries and Commerce, IT, ENC, Government of Telangana. May we also invite on stage Shri Arvind Singh, Chairman, Airport Authority of India, Srimati Usha Pari, Joint Secretary, Ministry of Civil Aviation, Government of India, Shri Anand Stanley, Chairman, FICCI Civil Aviation Committee and Managing Director, Airbus India. To start this event, may I please request Shri Anand Stanley to felicitate our Chief Guest and Honorable Minister and other dignitaries, Shri Hardeep Singh Puri. Sir, thank you very much for joining us today for the Ministerial Plenary. Can you please welcome our Honourable Minister with a warm round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. Shri, in the same line of thought, Shri K.T. Rama Rao. Shri Arvind Singh. So thank you for joining us today. And Srimati Usha Pari. And may I now request Shri Arvind Singh to deliver the welcome address.
Honorable Minister for Civil Aviation, Shri Hardeep Singh Puriji. Honorable Minister for IT, Telangana, Shri K.T. Rama Rao. Shri Anand Stanley, who is President of the Civil Aviation Committee in FICCI. My colleague, Usha Pari. Representatives from different governments, representatives of media, ladies and gentlemen. It's my privilege today to welcome our civil aviation minister, and especially, you know, for him to have spare time in this at this moment when parliament is in session, when there are umpteen groups of ministers going on the issue of coronavirus. And there are innumerable meetings that are happening in Delhi for him to have found time and to be here. So I will take this opportunity to welcome him and thank him on behalf of the organizing committee of this Wings 2020. A warm welcome again to Mr. K.T. Rama Rao, who's been with us since yesterday. And without whose support and without the support of the Telangana government, this event would not have been possible. All of us are aware that there is a very good future that awaits the Indian civil aviation industry. India is poised to become one of the largest markets, in fact the third largest market in civil aviation in a few years. And we had a series of deliberations and discussions yesterday. One of the roundtable discussions which I happened to chair was with all the airline representatives, the aircraft manufacturers, OEMs, leading OEMs from the world. We had leading airline representatives and, of course, leading airport operators also from the country. And the theme in that roundtable, which I would like to just inform the minister because he's here today, was that we have to move to the next phase of development. As far as airports are concerned, we have to concentrate, of course, on the six metros because they are the ones where all the growth is. We have to move to high-intensity operations and think of developing sub-hubs. Then we have to move on to the next phase, which is to develop second airports in towns and cities where there is no scope of further expanding the existing airport, which is already constrained. Examples such as New Delhi or Pune or even Mumbai, where there is limited scope for expansion of the existing airport. And the third was to take the growth and the addition in infrastructure to the hinterland, because we are seeing a large growth in traffic in Tier 2 and Tier 3 cities in the country. And, you know, this is where the Udaan scheme in which we have operationalized a number of airports come in. So the broad theme was that this is the next phase that we have to look out, that, you know, now aviation has to reach to the underserved and unserved airports. It is to reach to the areas which are yet untapped. So with these words, I would welcome all of you again to the second day of this conference. And I'm sure that you'll enjoy the success of this event, which is and has always been one of the significant events in Asia. And I'm sure, given the circumstances, we had to curtail it this year, but the next event will definitely be a bigger one. Thank you and welcome to you all.
Thank you very much, Mr. Singh, for that warm welcome. Moving ahead, may I now request Sri Anand Stanley to set the context for the session.
Thank you very much. Adraniya Mantri Ji, Sri Hardeep Singh Puri Ji, Gauraniyalu Mantri Garu, KTR Garu, Pedulandariki Namaskaralu Ivvala, Adraniya Sri Arvind Singh Ji, Madam, Sri Mati Usha Padi Ji. FICCI is proud to host this Wings India event and to support the as a partner, and I am here to give you the overview of the industry from a FICCI standpoint. Very quickly, the elephant in the room I want to start with is this coronavirus. I do want to remind everyone that we've had SARS, we've had MERS, we've had 9/11, we've had the financial crisis. In the last 18 years, domestic traffic has still grown 14 times. That is 1400%. And we have grown from a very low number to number 3 in the world. Total traffic has grown 8.2x, including international traffic. The economy has grown over 7% GDP CAGR. Despite this crisis, India is now the fifth largest economy in the world, and we will be the third largest economy. And despite this crisis, we will be the largest country in the world within the next few years. So let me underline this, what the future looks like in terms of the industry and connectivity. We have been connecting the country using UDAN. And with that, per capita trips have gone from 0.1 per person to 0.5 per person. We've had hubs, as discussed, all over India. Every minute, an aircraft lands or takes off. And we are going to look forward to going to 1 billion passengers in India, as the FICCI study has shown last year. International, we will grow to 200 airports, and we have the vision that India will become an international eye-to-eye hub with eye-to-eye capability. Within the cities, we are looking forward to urban mobility. Even cities like Hyderabad, which is growing at 50% higher than the GDP growth and 6 times higher than the growth of many advanced countries, we look forward to air taxis. We have done last year about 10,000 crores of aerospace exports from India, and we believe that we as a sector will support the Prime Minister's goal of $5 billion of exports in a few years, as we are already at $1.5 billion of exports in this sector. We will connect to ensure that the MRO, that 100% of Indian aircraft are serviced from India, in India, and beyond India. We want this to be our forte of digital, that we can drive artificial intelligence, blockchain, quantum computing, and be able to lead the world in this area, not just lead, but leapfrog in this area, in the area of aerospace. By 2040, FICCI had, with the Ministry of Civil Aviation, set the vision that 100% of the aircraft will have parts or will be having manufacturing components or even be manufactured in India. And last but not least, most important, Indians themselves, the people, the talent, the goal that we are. Today we employ 200,000 people directly in this sector, 1 million people. We look forward to, in the time to come, despite all the challenges, for that number to go through 5 million people. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much, dignitaries. Jai Hind.
Thank you very much, Mr. Stanley. And now, ladies and gentlemen, I request Sri K.T. Rama Rao Garu to address the gathering.
Honorable Minister of Civil Aviation, Sri Hardeep Singh Puri Ji, Airport Authority of India, Chairman Sri Arvind Singh Ji, Joint Secretary Civil Aviation, Srimati Usha Padi Ji, and my friend and MD of Airbus India, Sri Anand Stanley Ji, to all the distinguished aviation industry leaders and to the gathering here, ladies and gentlemen, to my friends from the media. Good morning to all of you. Minister Sir, we have had a long, a day yesterday with lots of discussions, lots of B2B meetings. As we all know, this event has been curtailed and has been converted into a B2B meeting, and adequate safety precautions have also been taken, as I'm sure you would all agree, because as you walked in, I'm sure you were all thermally screened, and then enough sanitizer to go around for all of us. And in spite of, as Anand called it, in spite of the elephant in the room, in spite of the health scare that is going on around the world, this event has been largely successful. And I think thanks to the industry, thanks to Ministry of Civil Aviation for giving us an opportunity to host this wonderful event in the city of Hyderabad. Look forward to continuing this event with more enthusiasm and with continued support from Mr. Puri and his entire team. Sir, if I have to share with you a couple of things, yesterday, in fact, as part of the inaugural, we spoke about a state like Telangana, in fact, being at the forefront of creating more airports as part of the regional connectivity scheme. Also, bringing in heliports and possibly looking at more options such as seaplanes, etc. But the one thing I would like to stress upon, sir, is with respect to aviation and also aerospace, as Anand Stanley pointed out, there has been tremendous growth, 1400% as he called it. And there is enough room to grow for all of us. In fact, I've heard a couple of numbers which were staggering. Next 20 years, I believe India is likely to procure 2,400 aircrafts, subject to correction, of course. So therefore, the future looks incredibly optimistic, both from civil aviation and defense aviation perspective. But I think the one key thing, if we all have to do from government's perspective to be enabling this to happen, is the focus on skilling. In Telangana, in fact, we've forged some very interesting partnerships with Embry-Riddle, with Cranfield, with also others, Aero Campus Aquitaine, and all other in leaders in skilling and you know, training courses. We also have inaugurated, as part of the Wings 2020, we also have inaugurated a fantastic flight simulator, FSTC, in the Shamshabad Airport. We possibly could focus as governments on two specific sectors, one of which is MROs, I think, which is likely to create huge, huge employment potential, huge, huge opportunity to bring in huge investments into our country. So the one request I had shared with you in the past, sir, with respect to MROs is, we've had many bilateral discussions with potential investors. They were worried about GST. I hope Government of India will soon take a policy decision on this. And second aspect is skilling. I think today India has the potential to train pilots, potential to train aircraft engineers, not just for itself, not just for its own domestic sector, but also to, you know, pilots and aircraft engineers and other maintenance staff who operate in the Middle East, who operate in Southeast, who operate, in fact, as far as Africa and Far East as well. And now this, again, is a huge opportunity to create more employment opportunities for our youngsters. So I hope on these two fronts, on MRO and also on skilling, I hope Ministry of Civil Aviation takes a positive view, and I hope we'll bring in any reforms and any new policies that will enable us to create more employment opportunities for young Indians. Once again, I compliment and I congratulate the entire team of Ministry of Civil Aviation and my Principal Secretary, Jayesh Ranjan, all the Telangana government officials here as well, who have made sure that this event has happened very, very successfully. Thank you very much. And once again, I welcome the Honorable Minister to Wings 2020. Cheers.
Thank you very much, sir, for sharing your thoughts with all of us. Ladies and gentlemen, at this point in time, I'd like to direct your attention onto the screen. We have a special audiovisual message by His Excellency, Mr. Yu Thon Sin Muang, Union Minister for Transport and Communication, Myanmar. Can we please play his video message?
Excellencies, distinguished delegates, ladies and gentlemen, I'm very pleased to join you through this video clip. I wish to congratulate the Ministry of Civil Aviation, the Government of the Republic of India, and the Federation of Indian Chambers of Commerce and Industry for organizing this important event in civil aviation, Wings India 2020. In the meantime, I also wish to thank my friend, His Excellency Sri Hardeep Puri, Honorable Minister of State, for Housing and Urban Affairs, Civil Aviation, Commerce and Industry, inviting me to take part in this flagship event. Ladies and gentlemen, I would first like to share with you that Myanmar and India have a long history of cooperation in the aviation sector. Our flag carriers, Union of Burma Airways, now Myanmar National Airlines, and India Airlines, now Air India, linked the two countries since 1950s. The first air service agreement between Myanmar and India was signed in 1979 and updated in 2012. With liberalized provisions in the existing air services agreement, Myanmar Airways International, Air India, and Indigo Airlines are currently operating 18 wheeling services between the two countries. Passenger traffic they carried has increased year over year at an average annual growth rate of 13%. In order to keep moving this upwards, I ask airlines from both sides to fly more to each other's countries. For the government's role, I assure that we will work closely to facilitate airlines' operation aiming at further strengthening people-to-people linkages and economic cooperation between the two countries. Ladies and gentlemen, I have no doubt that this event will surely identify opportunities and challenges that aviation has to offer and support our future work in aviation. Last but not least, I thank all of you for your kind attention and wish a fruitful event. Thank you.
Thank you so much, His Excellency, Mr. Yu Than Sing Muang, for that wonderful message, and we look forward to a great collaboration as well, sir. Moving ahead, ladies and gentlemen, we are now going to witness the exchange of tripartite MOU under Ministry of Civil Aviation Krishi Udan Scheme by Ras Al Khaimah International Airport, GMR Hyderabad International Airport Limited, and SpiceJet Limited. Can we please request the concerned authorities to join us on stage and exchange the MOUs in front of our Honourable Minister? The tripartite MOU between Ras Al Khaimah International Airport, GMR Hyderabad International Airport Limited, and SpiceJet Limited. Can we please request our media to please give way for our guests to join us on stage? And while the tripartite MOU exchange happens, our second MOU exchange will be between the government of Telangana, Airbus, and GMR Hyderabad International Airport. Can we please request the concerned authorities to be ready with the same? Our members from the media, if you can just slow down and cooperate with us. The videography team can also capture this moment. Thank you. Can we just quickly take a moment to also give our electronic media a chance to capture this moment? Photographers, please. Thank you for that exchange of tripartite MOU. Thank you. Can we please request the concerned authorities from the government of Telangana, Airbus, BizLabs, and GMR Hyderabad International Airport for our second MOU exchange? Can we please invite the concerned authorities from government of Telangana, Airbus, BizLabs, and GMR Hyderabad International Airport to kindly exchange their MOUs in presence of our Honorable Minister? $1 of checks. Our photographers team, if you can just also give an opportunity for our electronic media to capture this moment, we'd highly appreciate that. Our next MOU is between the government of Telangana and DJI. Can we please request the concerned authorities to join us on stage for the same? We are now witnessing the MOU exchange between Government of Telangana and DJI. And up next, may we request, we are now going to have the MOU exchange between the Government of Telangana and Asia Pacific FTO and Marut Drones. Can we request the concerned authorities to join us on stage for the same? Ladies and gentlemen, an MOU exchange between Government of Telangana, Asia Pacific FTO, and Marut Drones. Congratulations to all the concerned authorities, and we look forward to an extremely fruitful collaboration in future. Moving ahead, ladies and gentlemen, thank you, sir. Thank you to all the dignitaries. Ladies and gentlemen, in the month of April 2016, our Honorable Prime Minister initiated a 15-day cleanliness program called Swachhata Pakhwada with an objective of intense focus on issues and practices of Swachhata by engaging organizations under ministry's jurisdiction, and this was to be followed every year. This is the fourth consecutive year that the Ministry of Civil Aviation has organized such pakhwadas, and in the year 2019, for the very first time, private partners also enthusiastically participated in the same. Some major activities undertaken during Swachhata Pakhwada 2019 were: Airport Authority of India has declared 85 airports as single-use plastic-free airports. Swachhata brochures provided by the DDWS placed in seat pockets in all flights operating from Delhi. The in-flight announcements regarding Swachhata awareness, including Swachhata anthem, were being made on board. Paper recycling unit of AAI planned to share expertise of recycling paper with other agencies, ministries, and PSUs. We then had various competitions like drawing, poetry, speech competition, short plays, inviting innovative ideas for Swachhata amongst employees. PHL sponsored Shram Pad Yatra and Shram Dan activities in association with neighboring corporates and floating solar plant. CIL successfully charged a floating solar power plant in Lake in the Gulf Coast on 25th November 2019. It's a pilot project with a capacity of 423 kWp. Now, as a result of these practices over the last year, we have identified Swachhata winners in five categories. Ladies and gentlemen, as we announce your name, please join us here on stage to receive your award, and maybe request our Honorable Minister to do the honors of conferring the Swachhata Pakhwada Awards 2019. Our first category for this is private airlines, and under this category, the first award, the first prize goes to Vistara. Can we please request team Vistara to join us on stage? And ladies and gentlemen, let's have a huge applause for all our awardees. I request our Honorable Minister and other dignitaries on stage to confer this award. And as Team Vistara joins us on stage to collect their award, in the same category of private airlines, the second award goes to Go Air. Can we request Team Go Air to be ready? Congratulations, Team Vistara. Let's have a loud cheer for Team Vistara, ladies and gentlemen. Congratulations, sir. And second prize goes to Team Go Air. So please join us here on stage to receive your award. Can we please have a huge applause for Team Go Air, ladies and gentlemen. The second winner in private airlines category under Swachhta Pakwara Awards 2019. The third prize in this category goes to, it's jointly shared by two airlines, and in no particular order, we will invite them on stage one by one. IndiGo. Can we request Team IndiGo to join us on stage to receive the reward? And the second winner in this category, the third award under private airlines, goes to Team AirAsia. Congratulations, sir. Please join us here to receive your award. If you can please keep the aisle clear, it will just help our participants to join us on stage quickly. And as Team AirAsia joins us on stage to receive their award, we have another consolation award in this particular category. Can we have a huge round of applause for AirAsia, ladies and gentlemen? Our consolation prize in this category goes to Team SpiceJet. Can we please have a huge round of applause for SpiceJet? And can we request a representative from Team SpiceJet to join us on stage? Sir, please join us. So with that, we come to the end of the category for private airlines, and the second category is private airports. And the first award, the first prize in this category, ladies and gentlemen, goes to Cochin International Airport Limited. A huge applause for Cochin International Airport. Can we request Team Cochin to join us here on stage to receive the award? Congratulations, sir. And the second prize in private airports goes to Bengaluru International Airport Limited. Team Bengaluru, sir, please join us here on stage. Congratulations. Can we have a huge round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, for Team Bengaluru? And the third winner in this category, again jointly shared by two airport authorities in no particular order, ladies and gentlemen. First up, I'd like to invite Mumbai International Airport Limited. Congratulations, Team Mumbai. And the second winner for the third prize in private airport is backed by our very own Hyderabad International Airport Limited. Can we request Team Hyderabad to join us here on stage to receive their award? Congratulations, sir. With that, we come to the end of a private airports category. We now move towards the third category, which is PSUs under Ministry of Civil Aviation. And the first award in this category, the first award under PSUs under Ministry of Civil Aviation, goes to Air India Limited. Can we please request Team AIL to join us here on stage? Air India Limited. Yes, Team Air India. Can we please have a huge applause, ladies and gentlemen? They win the first prize under PSUs under Ministry of Civil Aviation. The second award in this category goes to Pawan Hans Limited. Team PHL. All right, I want to hear a loud cheer. Come on, ladies and gentlemen, please let's give them a huge round of applause. Thank you. And the third award in this category goes to Airport Authority of India. A loud cheer for Team AAI. Moving on to our fourth category. Our fourth category is for clean and safe airports under Airports Authority of India. Now, under this category, we have three subcategories. And the first subcategory is annual passenger traffic 5 million and above. And the first prize in the subcategory goes to Team Kolkata. Can we invite Kolkata to join us here on stage as they win the first prize under annual passenger traffic 5 million and above, the clean and safe airports under Airports Authority of India. Congratulations, Team Kolkata. The second award in the subcategory goes to Team Chennai. Can we please invite Chennai on stage? Congratulations, Team Kolkata. Let's hear it for Chennai, ladies and gentlemen. The second prize in annual passenger traffic, 5 million and above. The third prize in the subcategory goes to Jaipur, the pink city of India. Team Jaipur, please join us here on stage to receive awards. Sir, please join us. Congratulations, Team Jaipur. We now move to the second subcategory, which is annual passenger traffic between 1.5 million and 5 million. And the first prize in the subcategory, the first award in this category goes to Madurai. Can we please have a huge round of applause for Team Madurai? Yeah, they are just joining us. Sir, please make it real quick. We are waiting for you here on stage. Team Madurai, ladies and gentlemen. And the second prize in annual passenger traffic between 1.5 million and 5 million is Team Chandigarh. Can we invite Team Chandigarh on stage? Congratulations, Madurai. Team Chandigarh, the second prize for annual passenger traffic between 1.5 million and 5 million. Can we please give them a huge round of applause, ladies and gentlemen? And as Chandigarh receives their award, the third prize goes to Trivandrum. Can we invite Team Trivandrum on stage? With that, we move to the third subcategory, which is annual passenger traffic between 1 million and 1.5 million. I beg your pardon. And the first award goes to Udaipur. Can you please give it up for Udaipur, ladies and gentlemen? Team Udaipur. Yes, congratulations, sir. The second prize in the subcategory goes to Vadodara. Let's have a huge round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, for Team Vadodara, the second award for annual passenger traffic between 1 million and 1.5 million. And the third prize in the subcategory goes to Vijayawada. A huge round of applause for Team Vijayawada, ladies and gentlemen. And with that, we come to the end of this category, which is Clean and Safe Airports under AAI. We now move to our next category, which is Government Organization under Ministry of Civil Aviation. And the first prize, the first award in this category goes to Indira Gandhi Rashtriya Udan Academy, IGRUA. Can we please invite the team here up on stage? Indira Gandhi Rashtriya Udan Academy. They win the first award in the government organization under the Ministry of Civil Aviation. Congratulations, sir. Let's have a loud cheer for them, ladies and gentlemen. The second prize goes to Directorate General of Civil Aviation. Can we please give them a huge round of applause? Team DGCA, let's hear for them, ladies and gentlemen, the last few awards for the day. And the third prize is backed by Bureau of Civil Aviation Security, BCAS, Team BCAS. Congratulations, sir. With that, we come to the end of this award category as well. And we have one last award, which is credited to Alliance Air for appreciating for active participation under RCS Udan scheme in Northeast region. Ladies and gentlemen, let's give it up for Alliance Air. We humbly appreciate them for their active participation under RCS Udan scheme, Northeast region. Moving ahead, ladies and gentlemen, we'd also like to take this opportunity to acknowledge and appreciate our various state governments for this earnest support and contribution in making Wings India 2020 a huge success. In no particular order, we're going to invite the state governments on stage. We'll start with our host state, the government of Telangana. Can we please request Jay sir, please join us here on stage to please kindly accept this certificate of appreciation and acknowledgement. Can we please give it up for Team Telangana, ladies and gentlemen? Up next, as Team Telangana receives the certificate, we'd like to acknowledge and appreciate the Government of Haryana. Government of Haryana. Thank you, Team Haryana, for your unending support towards making Wings India 2020 a huge success. The third state, moving ahead, we'd like to acknowledge is the Government of Andhra Pradesh. Let's hear it for Team Andhra Pradesh. And as Andhra Pradesh walks up, the next state that we'd really like to acknowledge is the government of Gujarat. Can we please give it up for the state of Gujarat, ladies and gentlemen? Thank you, Team Gujarat. And last but surely not the least, our state next that we'd really like to appreciate and acknowledge is the government of Maharashtra. Government of Maharashtra. Ladies and gentlemen, let's quickly give a huge round of applause for all the award winners and all the states. They've contributed immensely to, you know, uplift this entire event to a whole new level. Thank you to all the state governments and heartiest congratulations to all the award winners. And now, so thank you, sir, for doing the honors. It's extremely kind of you. Thank you. The moment that we had all been waiting for, I request Honorable Minister Shri Hardeep Singh Puri to address the gathering.
Shri K.T. Ramarao ji, he is not only an efficient and dynamic minister, but he is also in many respects a representative of what the new India that we are working towards looks like. And I regard it as a personal privilege that I've had the pleasure of his privilege of his friendship for the entire duration of my being in the Council of Ministers, and we worked together not only in the on the various flagship missions of the central government, the Prime Minister in the urban space, but I'm equally delighted that thanks to him, we are him and his colleagues in the government, his entire team, we have a very successful Wings 2020 conference, so I want to personally record my gratitude and appreciation to that. Thank you very much. I also want to start by thanking FICCI. As an organization, my friend Dilip Shenoy, the Secretary General, Mr. Anand Stanley, the Chief of Airbus India, also the head of the FICCI Civil Aviation Committee, my own senior management, the chairman of the Airports Authority, Arvind Singh Ji, and last but not least, my very dynamic Joint Secretary Usha Padhi Ji, who I think you will all agree has been the moving spirit behind this. I have been a civil servant myself for nearly four decades. and I have always maintained that in any government which functions efficiently, the joint secretary level is where governance takes place. I am not saying this because Arvind, you are now additional secretary, soon to become secretary, or Pradeep is not here. But the fact of the matter is that the joint secretary, I think that's the also the rank in the government where we spend the maximum amount of time. And only the very best to become joint secretaries, and they stay there, and then they, of course, become heads of department and so on. But Usha, in, I must tell you, has personally spearheaded this. She's been the driving force. And when somebody started saying that there's an elephant in the room, as it's been referred to here by one of the previous speakers, I think Arvind, I was very clear that we would have an equally successful wings in spite of the elephant, and we would show how this can be done differently. And this morning's function and your excellent outcomes of yesterday bear eloquent testimony to that. I have a prepared speech which my social media team will of course happily put out, what all the wise things that need to be said on this occasion. Let me utilize this occasion to speak from the heart on a few things which I think are priority attention deserving. Let me start by addressing upfront the so-called elephant in the room. I think the time has come for us to acknowledge that globally, yes, this is and will continue, at least for the foreseeable future, to be one of the major challenges which the global community has to face, and which the civil aviation sector in particular has to confront. That it is a challenge goes without saying. But how well prepared are we to face this challenge? And I want to confine my remarks to India. And I am going to make before you, I'm going to place before you a few submissions. And then I want to develop a perspective based on those facts. Information regarding the coronavirus came into the public domain, I think, towards the end of December 2019, towards the last few days. The WHO, or the World Health Organization, pronounced itself, I think, in terms of a serious global emergency, I think around the end of January. But I can place before you that we had started acting on it on the 17th of January. I don't want to take your time in outlining what all actions we took all over the world. Air India conducting missions to bring back our citizens who were in Wuhan, the epicenter of the coronavirus, other flights which have been sent, what we have been doing more recently, bringing our citizens back from Iran, Italy, and the most affected countries in the world. But I think the time has now come to take stock and to be able to make an assessment of what we have achieved so far and where we are heading. What we need to acknowledge up front, that this is one of those situations which is being personally monitored and directed by the Prime Minister personally, along with his office, the Prime Minister's office. There is a group of ministers under the chairmanship of the Health Minister, whose membership comprises the External Affairs Minister, the Minister for Civil Aviation, Shipping, and so on. And then there is a group headed by the Cabinet Secretary, which includes the secretaries and the relevant ministries. We were able to take a lot of coordinated decisions, but those which are relevant to the civil aviation sector, I want to place before you now. Within hours of even the first evidence becoming available, we had started screening passengers coming in from the 12 most affected countries. We increased that on 4th March to include screening of all passengers coming in from any country in the world. Why did we do that? Because whilst we were able to effectively monitor people coming in from the most affected countries, it became clear that given the advanced integration and globalization that we are all part of, many people have a travel history. They may be traveling from a non-affected area, but their travel history may involve having a visit to one of the most affected areas and therefore creating a new challenge. Also, it became clear that this is a virus which an individual can carry. The symptoms may not necessarily show, and that the incubation period for that is therefore longer. So you needed to screen just about everyone. We were able to do that effectively. 30 of our airports which deal with passengers coming in from foreign destinations or international traffic, this system is in place. I am not one who easily subscribes to self-certification, but my senior colleague, the chairman of the Airports Authority, my other members of the senior management of the ministry, they not only monitor what people are saying in the Indian social media, but what people are saying in the rest of the world. And I think our airports today constitute a benchmark for how airports globally should be run in situations like this. So I want to congratulate not only the Airports Authority, but the airport operators, particularly the bigger ones, the 30 where these checks and screening is being done. Let me be very clear. For us, one case is one case too many. And once you work on that and work backwards, then I think the chances of your getting it right are higher. We have, as of the latest figures, I was traveling with Mr. Ajay Singh there, and we were discussing the scenario, and I said, I'm going to get the latest figure. The latest figures I've got are, since we started this, we have screened 10,876 flights. 10,876 flights coming in from outside, which means many of them were wide-bodied planes. So you can gather what kind of a task this is. We have screened 11,71,061 passengers, 12 lakh passengers or so. And I think this figure goes up as we speak. 3,225 of these 12 lakh passengers required further screening. If you look at the global figures of most seriously affected countries and where India fits in, I think the fact is that we take in these people for screening, but we don't seem to be concentrating on the fact that many of the people who came in, let's say from Wuhan, and who were quarantined, have now been released because they're okay. They tested positive in terms of the virus. They were kept under observation for the prescribed period, and now they're all right. To give you an idea about the extent to which due diligence is done, let me explain to you that in many cases, if a person is discovered because of a travel history to have visited one of the most seriously affected places and shows the symptoms, sometimes 80, 100, even more people who may have come in contact with that person are then screened separately. We have a situation today where we have about 80 or so known cases. Many of them are recovered or will be recovering. They're being constantly monitored. We have two cases where unfortunately there have been fatalities. Both these cases are in terms of the age profile and in terms of pre-existing medical conditions, they would fall in a particular category. But let me also share with you, and this is very necessary because there is a tendency whenever we are confronted with a challenge like this to turn around and say, let's stop all activities. Now, you know, and thereby inadvertently, perhaps not deliberately, but inadvertently, you contribute to what is what I call the creation of a sense of uncertainty or heightened uncertainty or even panic. More than 42% of the cases where people have succumbed have an age profile of 79 years and above. So, most people who are healthy, hopefully, even if they test positive, they have the resilience, their immune system that they will help overcome. And we as a government have to ensure that we do that. That means taking precautions. That means you would have seen me utilizing a hand sanitizer, and my friend KTR said, you know, the press will focus on that. I said, yes, hopefully with the right message, that we should go about our jobs, take whatever precaution. Our aircraft should be disinfected. Meeting places should be disinfected. Is there going to be some economic disadvantage that we are going to be placed to? Well, I continue, as in most other things I deal with in life, to be an optimist. Yes, there may be a 15-20% drop in domestic traffic for the time being, but I believe that also is a passing phase. I am absolutely sure that once people get the correct perspective, know where we are vulnerable, take precautions against that, look at the numbers who are recovering, and the number is pretty impressive. I mean, I tell you, when the figure was 31, I looked at those cases individually. Out of those 31, 16 belonged to a tourist group which came from one country, and the 17th was the driver attached to them. Now, if you have a population of, I don't know, somebody put the population 1.24 billion, I think it's a little more than that. I mean, when the census next year will tell you, but it should be closer to 1.3 billion. Out of 1.3 billion, you done the screening, you found 3,225 people need more screening. You have 80 positive cases. Many of them are going to be okay. You'll add some. Ladies and gentlemen, I submit to you that if you look at that perspective, we will not only overcome this challenge, but I see robust, vibrant growth in the civil aviation sector. And I completely agree with what my previous speakers, my colleagues said. We are not only the world's third largest domestic civil aviation market, but we are going well towards becoming the world's third largest civil aviation market. And I keep talking to my colleagues. They said from 345 million passengers per annum footfall, it's going to be a billion. But they put the billion at 2030. Look, I'm convinced with the kind of penetration we have and the growth rate we have, double-digit growth, in spite of all the other problems we've had, we will get to that billion passengers park much before 2030. And I'm going to be a little risky. You might be there by 2024, 2025 also. And this whole business about, how many aircraft there are. Look, I have always maintained that when the global scenario looks and is presented with challenges, that's the time when we step in. When the, what is the expression in the English language? When the going gets tough, the tough get going. And I have absolutely no doubt that our operators, our airlines in the private sector, our ecosystem, which the government is part, we can all work together, seize the opportunity, and demonstrate to the world that we looked at this challenge, not only took the measures required in order to ensure that we protect ourselves, but we took advantage of the changed circumstances. And I'm not meaning just the falling oil prices. But we have to do that, make sure the benefit of that goes on to there. Make sure that the other infrastructure, KTR mentioned, permit me for calling you KTR and not Honorable Minister KTR, but I think we've known each other long enough. MROs. I think Nirmala ji put it budget speech. You can have MROs, which are the need of the hour, skilling. You need to do it around the six major metros. And it's being done. I'm personally familiar with the aircraft manufacturers showing an interest. The fact that they are in an advanced stage of discussion with them. I'm aware of engine manufacturers doing that, and I'd be very happy as the minister holding that portfolio right now to say, see a good even geographic spread so that we bring the maintenance, repair, manufacturing to the country, utilizing what is happening now. And for them also, those who have to make the investment, see the clear advantage of doing it in India. You're going to have 2,000 aircraft in the skies here, and you've got the countries around our neighborhood. Surely, India being the hub can service all that. I have also maintained, and I have no hesitation in saying so on an event like this, we need to bring aviation turbine fuel in under GST. I'm hoping this can be done sooner than later, that it should be done yesterday, if not yesterday, today. And I say this with a sense of responsibility. I've written many letters. I've appealed to the chief ministers of state governments. I have written to the finance minister. And I think, by and large, that there is acknowledgement that this should be done, and it will be done very soon. You've done it. Good for you. Now we need to bring it over at the national level. Why I am particularly pleased today that Wings India 2020 is taking place. I can tell you there are guys, I have the privilege of three portfolios, so I have a different set of trolls going after me in each of those. Most of them say things and then look a little silly and then fall off this thing. I mean, Arvind and I have had to battle one case where somebody, two people in particular, somebody turned around and said they came through a major airport in South India and there was no screening. So that kept Arvind and his colleagues up for most of the night. Because, you know, social media is a great thing. You know, in the age when you didn't have social media, you had only print newspaper, somebody had to make sure that the guy saying something, you could print it only if somebody checked the credentials or, you know, whether there was some veracity in it. Here in social media, you can say anything. All right? And sometimes when you are being extra cautious in terms of prevention, we discovered that the gentleman had come in at least 12 hours before the screening procedures had been put in place. So he was making a point, but it didn't point to a lacuna in the system. In another case, a lady tweeted that she came through T3 in Delhi and found that there was no screening. That really set the cat amongst the pigeon. Till it took about 5, 6, 8 hours, we discovered not only CCTV footage of her going through the thermal scanner, but she admitted as much, except she said, but there was no doctor to examine me. Well, if you were not showing symptoms, the doctor was not going to be examining you. And because if you have capacity which is not unlimited, then you want to utilize those resources and that capacity in order to be able to focus on what is really doable. So we not only decided to go through with Wings 2020, I'm delighted that you've had a very good day yesterday. And the figures that I see, 110 exhibitors, 35 foreign representation. Of course, I suggested, after having written to the ministers of those countries, I said we were going to change the format. We were going to get people sending their messages, their interventions through video conferencing, as you saw one earlier today. We have 23 of our states participating, which is a very impressive number. We've had 271 meetings with states, 15 aircraft on display, 10,000 square meters of exhibition area, and 600 delegates. Now, if you ask me, when we took the decision, what were we up against? Well, the trolls were telling us immediately it should be cancelled, this should happen, that should happen. That would have been the easier thing to do. And if you take that kind of a mindset and apply it across the board everywhere else, then, well, then you don't take advantage of a challenge and come out stronger. Then something else happens, which is what? Which is that, look, challenge is there. Do we have the wherewithal to meet the challenge? I submit to you, we do. We are demonstrating that, but we are going a step further. We are going to utilize this challenge to become stronger after that. There may be some lessons we will learn in terms of operating procedures. I think the bonding this crisis, if I may call it that, has shown between the Ministry of Civil Aviation, the state governments, all the ecosystem stakeholders here, the ministries of external affairs, health, etc., shows that governments can, in the shortest period of time, rise to the occasion and take measures across WEG. You can send, we have medical teams in Iran testing people. We have medical teams in Italy testing people. And I believe, and please note, this is being done in a manner where the state is undertaking this. There are some very advanced countries in the world, I don't want to take a snipe, where people are not getting tested because a test is not covered under what is called medical insurance, and private sector people are charging $500 to $1,000. Look at the marked contrast with India. I mean, we are only a $3 trillion economy. We are going to become a $5 trillion economy, and by the time you get your billion passengers figure in 2030, I think it's going to be in 2024, we'll be in 2030, in any case, we'll be $10 trillion and the third largest economy. But I believe it shows something which is uniquely Indian, which is we have the capacity to work together and come out much stronger. So I don't want to take more time than I've already done. As I said, if anybody wants to quote me, my speeches will be out on the social media. But I took this occasion to speak from the heart. I think the time has come for us now to contribute to a different narrative, to say, yes, this is a challenge. We are meeting it. And believe me, the chances of anybody suffering from coronavirus are less than the odds which you have in crossing the road or in many other things. I don't want to list those out. So let's be conscious of what we are against and let's utilize this. And I want to once again congratulate all the stakeholders. I want to thank my friend and the government of Telangana for having provided this. I see many other very distinguished people in the audience, including honorable members of my party in the Rajya Sabha, Lok Sabha, Sir Ramesh, and so if I would start acknowledging everyone, we'd be here longer. But thank you all, and the very best, not only to all of you, but for, again, as I said, a quantum leap for the civil aviation sector hereafter. Thank you very much.
So thank you very much for A, opening your heart out and for sharing with us the facts and figures. And the fact that it comes from a policymaker like you is most definitely reassuring. I now request Srimati Usha Padhi to propose the vote of thanks.
Honorable Minister, Civil Aviation. Honorable Minister, Shri K.T. Ram Rao Garu. Our senior colleague, Chairperson, Airport Authority of India, Head of the Fiki family from Civil Aviation Vertical, Mr. Stanley, all my colleagues, participants, and industry captains. I am here to deliver vote of thanks. It's my honor to discharge that duty. I would have been very quick and formal. I could have completed formalities, sir, but this vote of thanks, I feel it's the biggest responsibility in the scenario where people have done so much. So it is my responsibility to at least acknowledge them. So please bear with me if I take a couple of minutes more. As Honorable Minister said, it was very easy choice for him to say no. But he took that stand where stood to his foot and strike that delicate balance between the public health scenario and the business opportunities. So this is where we could get his support and we could go ahead where all the participants also supported. As far as Telangana government is concerned, we are grateful to them. Whether it is rain or shine, they have been there with us. And especially, Sir Honorable Minister, you have been with us. So you know why we are coming to Hyderabad again and again. I also thank the entire team of Airport Authority of India under the chairman leadership of chairman and his entire team, my colleagues from MOCA and other attached officers. Many, even we did not ask, they came forward, said that we are there to take the responsibilities, please allow us to come. I am thankful to all the ministries who have supported from Government of India, whether it is the MEA, Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, or the IAF, who have been part of this spectacular event, and they have contributed their own bit. I will not be able to read all the list who have been there, but my sincere gratitude to all the participants from the industry. You have shown your passion. You have shown that how much you are committed for the cause of the growth in the sector. I mean it. You have traveled extra mile to be here and support this event. And believe me, since 2 days I have been seeing, sir, this elephant in the room was not taught by them at all. In fact, they have been in their business meetings, and there has been so much of optimism. And everybody is working and thinking of the future, and they know that India is poised to be the epicenter of the growth, and civil aviation is going to be the growth engine. So I am thankful to all those exhibitors, the representatives from the airlines, airports, the other ecosystem, who are able to work so efficiently on the ground so that our aircraft flew safe and securely in the sky. This is for all those people who are from the who are working on the ground. I will just list out whether it is the police, CASF, the Telangana State Infrastructure Development Department, Telangana State Aviation Corporation, DGCA, Customs, Immigration, GHMC, especially the municipal staff who have been there 24/7, making sure that this place is sanitized, clean, and all the precautions required for the public health safety has been followed. We have DHIL, BCAS, Fire Department, Hyderabad Water Supply, TS Electricity Board, CSF, the entire wing, Air India, AIESL, Ground Handler Bird Group, APHO, TS Public Health Services, especially the doctors and paramedicals. If you have seen all the three gates, I was little worried when Honorable Minister comes, what they do. But when the Minister came, I think they have also screened Minister and then left in. So, sir, we are very thankful to those health and paramedical staff who have been very committed and gave that confidence that we could go ahead with this event. So, everyone, one and all, who have helped to conduct this event very successfully. We have 1.5 days more. I'm sure that a lot of business have been lined up. There is a very important CEO forum after this. I am sure that most of you would be joining there, where Honorable Minister and all the dignitaries would be present. And after that, we will be having a press briefing also, so press will have a chance where Honorable Minister would be addressing the press. Immediately after this, we will be taking Honorable Minister out to the airside area. So we will have a gap to take the dignitaries and then maybe the other group, so that we can have staggered the crowd when they go to the airside. Please cooperate with us. This is for the Telangana government, sir. Sahakarinchina andaruku, Telangana Prabhutvamku, na krutagnatalu. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Usha ma'am, for this extremely kind and warm words. Ladies and gentlemen, with that, we come to the end of our ministerial plenary session. Our warmest regards and thank you to our Honorable Minister and KTR sir and other dignitaries on the stage. May we now invite our Honorable Minister towards the airside area, towards visit at the Mocha Chalet. We have an air show and a static display area. I'm sure Usha ma'am would be able to lead them for the same. Ladies and gentlemen, at 12:45, we have the Global CEO Forum at the hangar. I repeat, at 12:45, we have the Global CEO Forum at the hangar. At 2 p.m., after lunch, we assemble back here. There will be a press conference by our Honorable Minister. And at 2:45, we connect again for a plenary talk. After that,
Subscribe to our channel by clicking the subscribe button. Click the bell button and enjoy the latest uploads from our channel.